Welcome to Rasa Taste. Today I am going to make malai kofta. The ingredients required are fresh cream, 1/2 to 1 cup, water, maida 1/2 cup, oil, tomatoes 3 chopped, turmeric powder, garam masala 2 to 3 teaspoon, paneer 1/2 cup, cumin and coriander powder 2 teaspoon, red chilli powder, onion 2 chopped, salt to taste, butter 2 tablespoons, ginger and garlic crushed, badam 5, sugar 1 teaspoon, kasuri methi 1 teaspoon, potato 3 big, boiled, peeled and mashed, coriander and green chilies chopped finely. For making the koftas, before I start making the kofta, I have started to heat the oil on a low flame. So by the time when we finish making the koftas, the oil will be hot to fry the koftas. Now I have mashed the potatoes. Now this is freshly made paneer at home. You can use 200 grams of paneer if you are buying it. The quantity of paneer also depends on your taste. You can either reduce or increase the quantity of paneer and also the potato quantity according to your taste. Add salt. Add a teaspoon of garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon of freshly ground coriander and cumin powder, chilli powder according to your taste. I am adding little since we are adding green chilies. Now add the cut green chilies and the coriander leaves. Little I am going to save it for the gravy. Now add 3 tablespoons of maida or all purpose flour and knead it well together. Add salt also, which I forgot, I think. The maida is to bind the paneer with the potato. So in case if you feel that it is little loose, you can add little more maida. Check for the taste for the salt and the spiciness. You can add little more chilli and garam masala. Make it into a tight dough. You should make sure that the potatoes are very dry. It should not be wet. Now the mixture is ready. Apply little oil so that it won't stick to your hand. Now start making balls. The size of the balls can be little big or small depending on the size you want. I am making medium sized balls. Now after making the ball, just lightly dust it on the maida all purpose flour. Don't dust too much, just lightly you dust it and keep it ready. The same way you do for the rest of the mixture. Now I have made the balls like this. Now I am going to fry it in the oil. The oil is hot now. Keep it on low flame. Let it fry till it gets golden brown color. After few seconds we can turn it over to the other side. Now gently turn it. It has started to change color slightly. Gently turn it to the other side. Now the koftas are nice brown in color. I am going to remove it. keep doing for the remaining mixture. Let's start making the gravy. Add the butter. If you want to replace the butter with oil, you can add oil also. Let it get melted. Add the chopped onions. You can keep it on medium flame. Add the ginger garlic paste also. Fry for 2 to 3 minutes till it becomes soft. The onions have become soft. No need to fry it. It has become soft. Now add the chopped tomatoes. You can cut the tomatoes into big pieces also, since we are going to grind it. Add little salt. A little turmeric powder. Add the badam pieces also. If you have cashew, you can add cashew also. Let it fry for 2 minutes. Now it's done. Switch off the flame and allow it to cool. Then we can grind it into a smooth paste. Now the tomato onion mixture has become cool. Put it in a mixer jar. Grind it into a smooth paste. Now I have ground the tomato onion mixture into a smooth paste. In the meanwhile, I have heated a pan. Add three teaspoons of oil. Once the oil is heated, you can add a small piece of cinnamon and a bay leaf if you want. I have not mentioned it in the ingredient part. Keep it on medium to low flame. Add turmeric powder. Chili powder. We have added a little salt while grinding the onion tomato mixture, and for the kofta also salt is there. So for the gravy we need to add little salt. No need to add too much. You check for the salt. Add the coriander and cumin powder also. Fry a little. Then add the ground mixture. Mix everything well. Let it cook for 2 to 3 minutes till the oil separates out. Add little salt. Be careful while adding the salt. Since we have already added while grinding, you check for the salt. If required, you add. Otherwise, no need to add now. Let it fry. It's getting fried now. Add 1 to 1 and a half spoon of garam masala. The kasuri methi leaves also. Leave it for few seconds. Leave for a minute now. Now a minute is over. It is leaving the sides of the pan. Now add water. I have kept the water which I washed from the mixer jar. Add little more water to make the gravy. Let it cook for 2 minutes. While it is getting cooked, add the sugar. Little early also you can add the sugar. Check for salt one more time. I need little more salt and chili powder also. Check it and add if you want more. Let it cook. I have lowered the flame and I am going to close it for a minute. Now I am going to open it. It is but as boiling now. Reduce the flame. Now we are going to add the fresh cream. The quantity of cream depends on your taste. I am going to add around 100 ml of cream. Mix it well. You can see the gravy changing its color. Lower the flame and let it cook along with the cream for a minute. Now you can switch off the flame. It has cooked well. Add the chopped coriander leaves. Now when the gravy is very hot, don't add the koftas inside. Since the koftas will be soft, it might break. So if you want to add the koftas inside the whole gravy, you can do it after it cools down a little. Or you can serve like this also. At the time of serving, you can arrange the koftas and pour the gravy over the koftas just before serving, so that the koftas will not become soggy. Now tasty malai koftas are ready to be served with hot rotis. Hope you enjoyed watching this. Please subscribe to our channel Rasa Taste and give the video a thumbs up. Thank you.